This is the iHub in Nairobi. It's a creative workplace. Young IT entrepreneurs, programmers, designers, and technology fans exchange ideas here.
Okay. Hi, my name is Juliet Onyiri, and I'm currently the lead of Gearbox, which is the makerspace that we are excited to set up in Nairobi. And the need for this is that there's been a growing hardware community in Kenya.
And at Gearbox, they can run riot. They work with many computer modules, such as Raspberry Pi. Properly combined and programmed, these small computers can control almost anything from a distance.
We're making a product for Africa. It should come from Africa. But yeah, I'm definitely excited to see how things go. And being in iHub, you realize like a lot of people's ventures depend on the internet. And so we'll be helping their ventures run better. We'll also be doing a lot of final mile solutions.
Tanzania is still far from having comprehensive internet coverage. Only in Dar es Salaam is it more or less reliable. The women from Apps and Girls are fighting their way into the digital world, as Carolyn Ekirasima explains.
For secondary schools, we go there at least weekly together with my team, because I always call for girls who are willing to volunteer to train the girls. So we go there, we introduce them to coding.
In teams, secondary school girls get to know new programs. And fledgling businesswomen learn how to program websites themselves.
Some of us are shy when maybe we are with males. And all the competitions, the hackathons, winners used to be men. Once you're a woman or a girl and you're sharing together, you don't have this feeling, he's more smarter or he's competing with me. No, we are all the same and we are doing one thing.
The small country of Rwanda wants to become the Silicon Valley of Africa. Its economic growth is now more than 6%. Kigali is the first city in Africa to have high-speed wireless internet. Ideal conditions for creative spirits.
My name is Clarice Iribagiza, and I run a software company that focuses on building mobile applications. We've been doing this for 3 years now.
Especially in rural areas that don't have internet access, much business has to be done on the telephone. Iribagiza's company ensures that old, pre-smart cell phones can connect to the internet.
Our passion really is, you know, to focus on building homegrown solutions that are, you know, built around a community, you know, get feedback, improve the solutions, and just have a whole, you know, army. We call it an army of developers and people that really understand what the problems are and just helping us build this solution. If you want to be challenged and figure out how to solve problems that you've never even maybe thought would be there, this is the place that you'd definitely love to come.
So, programmers of the world, why wait? It's off to Africa.